The city of San Francisco has decided to ban e-cigarettes. It's not final yet, and it may face a legal challenge, and it may take 7 months to come in, but it is a huge move, is it? One that may be the start of something big. Well, the debate on e-cigarettes is still unsettled. Are they a gateway out of tobacco or a gateway into e-cigarettes and then maybe even real ones? The number of American teenagers who use nicotine products is rising fast, and that is put down to e-cigarettes. Martin Dockrell is head of the Tobacco Control Programme at Public Health England. Good afternoon to you, Martin. Where are you on e-cigarettes at the moment, and what is your advice to people about them?
Well, e-cigarettes are not completely risk-free, but far, far safer than smoking. So even the US National Academy of Sciences, who did a report about a year ago, said on the available evidence, far less harmful than smoking. So if you're a smoker, it makes a great deal of sense to switch and switch completely. If you don't smoke, there's no point in starting vaping. And what's more, hardly anybody does.
What do you think of San Francisco banning e-cigarettes?
Oh, it's a very strange thing. So they're still allowing you to buy combustible cigarettes, conventional cigarettes, that kill half of lifelong users. You can buy alcohol, you can buy cannabis, but you can't buy e-cigarettes, which are much less harmful. I don't get it at all, Evan.
So you wouldn't be advocating this here. I mean, because some people might say, look, we've got all those other habits, bad habits that people are already doing. That's one thing. It's hard to force people to break them. But we don't have to let people start on a new one, e-cigarette. So maybe just better to nip it in the bud while you can.
So Professor Robert West at University College London has calculated that in a typical year, we get 60,000 additional quitters from e-cigarettes, people who wouldn't have quit otherwise. We have about 3 million e-cigarette users in this country, and half of them have completely stopped. And one of the reasons they're motivated to stop is because here in the UK, we point out that e-cigarettes are far less harmful. In the US, they kind of say, oh, no, we don't know how harmful they're going to be. And smokers who are uncertain are much less likely to switch completely. We have really good data. And the worrying thing is that increasingly smokers are uncertain, and the less certain they are that e-cigarettes are safer, the more likely they are to carry on smoking.
So in fact, the fact that we're even debating it puts a sort of haze over the whole thing and makes people think, well, what's the point in switching out of one
exactly
dangerous
that.
Thing to another dangerous thing?
Yeah.
You couldn't have been clearer. Basically, if you're smoking, just stop and then get onto e-cigarettes if that's the way to stop.
It's
or stop both if you want. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, ultimately you can stop vaping, but the important thing is to carry on vaping until you're confident that you're not going to go back to smoking. So sometimes people worry, they say, my sister was one. She said, look, Martin, I'm going to, I'm on high nicotine now. I'm going to cut down to low nicotine, medium nicotine, no nicotine, then off completely. And I said, don't. Take your time, make sure you're not going to relapse to smoking, and then you can start cutting down. Well, she's on zero nic now, and that's great. But the really important thing is she's still not smoking.
Right. Martin Dockrell from Public Health England, the Tobacco Control Programme. You made your views very clear. Thank you very much for joining us.